Hi, in this video, I'll show you how to use the OpenSprinkler firmware update program to upgrade the firmware on your OpenSprinkler. To begin, you need a regular sized USB A to B cable like this one. Most printers use this type of cable. Also, it's highly recommended that you use the web interface's export configuration feature to save your existing programs and settings to a file, email, or local storage. This is because the firmware upgrade process will erase your existing settings, so having a backup copy will allow you to restore your programs and settings later. Next, go to opensprinkler.com, click on firmware update, that page, and then download the latest OpenSprinkler firmware update program. Unzip the downloaded file to a local folder, such as by dragging it to your desktop. There is an instructions.pdf in the folder, which you should read carefully before you proceed. The firmware update program is cross-platform, and you will find the executable corresponding to each of Mac OS, Windows, and Linux. Now, before proceeding to the next step, you need to check if driver is needed for your OpenSprinkler device. To do so, you need to know your OpenSprinkler's hardware version, which is usually printed on the label at the back of the device. However, if you can't find the label, there's a simple rule. If your OpenSprinkler comes with a green-colored 24-volt AC terminal block, it is version 2.0. And if it has a orange-colored terminal block, then it's version 2.1. For Mac and Linux, the driver installation, if needed at all, is pretty straightforward. For Windows 8 and 8.1, the driver installation can be tricky. I will show you how it works at the end of this video. For now, let's assume that you have the necessary driver installed already. Next, run the firmware update program. Now, if you are using Mac and encounter this error, you just have to go to System Preferences, Security and Privacy, and unlock the settings. Then select Allow Apps Downloaded from Anywhere. This should allow you to run the program. Now click on Download Firmware. This will automatically grab the latest firmwares from the OpenSprinkler's GitHub repository. Then insert the USB cable into OpenSprinkler's USB port and your computer's USB port. Click on Detect Hardware, and the program will automatically detect your hardware version. If you have OpenSprinkler 2.1, before you click on Detect Hardware, you need to enter bootloader first. To do so, turn off the controller, then press and hold push button B2 while inserting the USB cable, and then release the button within 1 to 2 seconds after plugging in the cable. The screen should remain off. If the screen lights up, then you have to repeat the procedure. So press and hold the button B2 and press and reinsert the cable and then release the button. Now click on Detect Hardware and the program should be able to find your OpenSprinkler. Once the hardware is detected, you should see the latest firmware version shown in the firmware drop-down list. You can then click on Upload Selected Firmware and wait for the upload process to complete. If you need to go back to any previous version, you can manually select the version from the firmware drop-down list. Please note that if you have OpenSprinkler 2.1, every time you upload a new firmware, you need to re-enter the bootloader and then click on Upload. Also, make sure that you wait till the device to reset its internal memory before unplugging the USB cable. If you missed this step, you can always do a manual reset afterwards. So feel free to try out the new firmware, and if everything looks fine, then you can use the web interface's import configuration feature to restore its previous settings and programs from your backup file. Okay, so coming back to Windows 8 and 8.1 users, if you have OpenSprinkler Hardware 2.1, let me show you how to install the required USB ASP driver. First of all, Windows 8 introduced a feature that requires a signed driver. And to be honest, this really complicates the open source development because many open source drivers, such as USB ASP, are not signed. But there is a workaround, that is to restart Windows 8 in a mode that disables driver signature enforcement. So there are many online tutorials that show you how to do this, and I'm just going to quickly go through the steps. First of all, move your mouse pointer to the lower right corner and then look for the settings icon. So click on the settings and then change PC settings here. Go to the update and recovery and click on recovery. And then next, look for the advanced startup. And then just click on restart now. And we'll come to this page. So at this page, click on troubleshoot and advanced options, startup settings. So this basically says, if you click on the restart button here, then you will be you will enter a special system menu which allow you to, for example, disable driver in signature enforcement. So let's restart. The system will reboot, and then you will see this screen. So if you look at the screen, number 7 is disable driver signature enforcement. So just press 7. So now we have rebooted into the system, but with the driver enforcement disabled. The next step is to follow the link in the instructions.pdf to download the USB ASP driver, which is on this page. I'm just going to download this zip file here. Okay. So, and then similar to before, we basically drag and drop the folder onto the desktop. And so this is the driver. The driver files are in this folder. And then next, we will connect OpenSprinkler 2.1 with the computer using the USB cable. Again, you know, we will enter the bootloading mode. So press and hold button B2 while inserting the USB cable, and then release the button after a couple seconds. So you hear that Windows has detected the device, but because it doesn't have the driver yet, if you have the device manager open, you will see that it shows USB ASP, but with a question mark. So next, what we're going to do is to right-click on that item and select update driver software. And so since we already have the driver, we don't have to search. Just click on browse my computer for driver software, and then give it the folder. So specifically, you know, you can just use the first subfolder. It's called the libusb_0.1.12.1. So just to select that folder and click on OK, and then next. And so notice that you're going to see this pop-up window which says Windows can't verify the publisher of the driver software, and just click on install this software anyway. So wait for the installation to complete. And now we're all set. And once the driver install is installed, you will see that the USB ASP appears under a category called libUSB Win32 device. Okay, so now let's go back to the firmware updater program. Let's run this. Run anyway. And then now if I click on detect hardware, as you can see, it has successfully detected the OpenSprinkler 2.1. So again, you know, this is really only needed if you have Windows 8 or 8.1 and you have OpenSprinkler 2.1, because the other versions of the operating system and also other versions of OpenSprinkler don't need this USB ASP driver. Okay, so that's all for this video tutorial. For additional details, you can visit opensprinkler.com and then go to the firmware update subpage. Thanks for watching this video.